1. API 653. Exam and study tips. In this module, you shall learn about how to apply for API 653 exam. What you shall expect during exam day. Exam time management and some exam tips. How the API exam questions developed? Periodically, a question writing session is conducted. Subject matter experts, SMEs, or individuals who specialize in storage tank, write questions from specific sections of the code. Each question is then checked by three other SMEs. This validation exercise checks two items. First, is the question written clearly? And second, does the question cover knowledge that is important to a vessel inspector? These questions then go into a question data bank. Presently, there are over 1,000 questions in the data bank and are grouped by topics. For each examination, there are 170 questions on the exam, of which only 140 are scored. The remaining are pretest questions and not scored. The non-scored questions are experimental questions. Out of 170 questions, 110 are closed book questions and 60 are open book questions. How to prioritize and plan your study for API 653. You have only a limited amount of time to study, so you need to invest your time wisely. That is, obviously, you should spend your study time where you can get the maximum return. Approximately half of the test questions directly come from API 653. So that's your priority. For every hour spent studying the other publications, spend 2 hours studying API 653. If you thoroughly understand API 653 and don't even look at the other publications, chances are you could pass the test based on your personal knowledge of other codes and recommended practices. We are not recommending this approach. But remember, almost half of API exam comes straight from API 653 inspection code. There will be about 70 to 75 test questions directly from API 653. API 653 has about 150 pages to study, which is an average of more than one question for every two page. The remaining 85 to 90 questions will come from some 2,000 pages contained in the other documents. That's only one question for every 20 pages. Spend your time mining in the rich veins of API 653. To do well in the exam, you must major on the majors, and minor on the minors. For this exam, API 653 is the majors. Time commitment. Time is your limited resource. Your learning efficiency will increase by having a plan and be focused. Why spend hundreds of hours studying haphazardly when you could learn just as much or even more within 50 hours of organized approach? Our e-learning course helps you manage your time as well as focusing on key subjects in an organized and effective manner. The plan can be based on 12 weeks of preparation with 6 to 8 study hours each week. This plan will allow you to study at a steady pace whenever you want and wherever you want. Your learning and satisfaction will significantly increase with this disciplined approach that also fit in with your daily. Do not wait and cram the week prior to the exam. You may still be lucky to pass the test, but you will soon forget what little you learned. Preparing for a certification exams is a great opportunity to really increase your inspection knowledge and skills. Make the most of it. How the questions are set. The examination comprises of open book and closed book parts. The closed book examination includes such questions which the inspector is normally expected to know. Without referring to the codes, that is, these questions are awareness level or practical type of questions. Whenever you find a very definitive or quantitative statement or fact in body of the code, a closed book question may be expected on it. Thus, the basic requirements of a code, specific do and don't statements, important quantified statements, important definitions, and well-known inspection principles will constitute such questions. Where the candidate is required to refer to the diagrams or formulas or tables or graphs and curves from the codes, it will always be an open book question. All calculation-oriented questions will be open book type. The code information, which is not short and crisp, that is, large paragraphs, several descriptive statements clubbed together, will normally be asked in open book part. Here the participant is expected not to remember the information, but should know where to find it in the body of the code. The questions asked in closed book part are straightforward statements directly taken from code without much of the modifications and therefore are easy to answer. Pay special attention to relevant figures, tables and footnotes. To answer open book questions, one only needs to know where to find the answer in the code and therefore tapping of code pages, highlighting the paragraphs or additional explanatory notes and page margins is useful and time-saving. We shall identify the important pages of codes during each module. During calculation type of mock exams, you should note the code pages that are frequented. Please note that it is very important to also work with the PDF version of the codes and RPS as it is quite different when you go through a hard copy of a code than when you go through the PDF format. You should get used to navigating through the PDF version as this is the medium you have to work through during the examination. Please remember that study of API 653 code has to be thorough and total, while study of ASME Section 5 and ASME Section 9 should be such that it can cover the topics mentioned in the body of knowledge. Our e-learning modules specifically focused on the body of knowledge. If you are about a month away from examination, read all the codes at least once and concentrate on highlighted text in the codes and also try to solve the question bank. If you are about 2 weeks away from the exam, concentrate on highlighted text as well as the mock examinations provided. In the last week of preparation, focus on flashcard and highlighted text from the codes and RP. Time management during the exam. Closed book part of the exam, 110 questions, can be finished within 2 to 2.5 hours. Against the allotted 2.75 hours. While open book part 60 questions takes a little longer and may require all the 3.75 hours that are allotted. Depending how fast you can find the relevant topic within the reference documents. Always keep a tab of the clock on the right-hand top corner of the computer screen. It shows the remaining time versus number of questions attempted. For closed book, you have an average of 1.5 minutes per question for closed book part and 3.75 minutes per question for open book. This means you should answer 40 questions per hour for open book part and some 16 questions for closed book part. It is always better to complete each part 15 to 30 minutes earlier and use it to review the flagged off questions, ensuring that all questions are answered to the best of your knowledge. You may start from question number 1 and proceed. If after 1 hour you feel that you are maintaining the speed, 40 questions per hour for closed book and 16 questions for open book, that is fine. If, however, you are behind the required progress rate, start jumping the questions, that is, start attempting those questions you can answer. Flag off or mark questions whose answer you do not know, to be reviewed at the end. Then, start reviewing marked questions by clicking Review Marked Questions tab and attempt them using your feel factor. Go on like this until say the last remaining 5 to 10 minutes. If there are still some questions where you have no clue at all, just mark the answer at random. This may give you few lucky points. Attempt all questions since there is no negative marking. Before the clock stops, make absolutely sure that all questions are answered. If you press the Review All button, you can also see whether you have answered all the questions or not. The exam stops automatically once you ran out of time. How do I prepare for classroom training? Note, this advice is more suitable for those candidates who have opted for our blended course, that is, the combined e-learning, plus our 5 days classroom training. The API body of knowledge covers a broad spectrum of knowledge which many inspectors might not be exposed on a regular basis. The classroom course is intensive, covering welding, NDT, WPS, codes, damage mechanism, inspection of storage tank and relief valves, explanation of important terms, exam tips and time management, as well as solving sample questions and Q&A sessions, all within 5 days. So, we expect that you have gone through the e-learning well enough, have a minimum level of knowledge but with a few glitches. The aim is to bring the candidates into an acceptable level of knowledge, so he or she is able to pass the examination. You paid a lot of money and we like high exam pass rates for our continued business. Remember, nobody can become an inspector by just a few days classroom training. But, we believe, if you have studied the e-learning modules, 5 day classroom training should be enough to cover the topics and to bottleneck any doubts you may have. The current e-learning provided, worth 60 to 80 hours of study material depending on your past experience and knowledge. Solving the mock questions and exams can take another 20 hours. Analyze the areas of knowledge you are already competent and then make a list of your weak areas. As long as your weak areas are not part of high percentage exam question segment, you are safe. Otherwise, you need to build up your strength on those areas to an acceptable level. We have designed the mock questions in such a way to complement your knowledge and be in line with actual exam questions. When solving the mock or sample review questions, you need to understand the underlying reason behind the right answer, and also try to understand why other answers are wrong. This would help you immensely during the real exam by avoiding mistakes and trick questions. We have explained the reason for each correct answer whenever needed. Study the e-learning regularly. Do not leave it until the day before the class and then cram for hours. It rarely works. Everyone is different. But the more preparation you do, the easier the class to follow, and finally the easier to pass the exam. Make notes on areas you may face difficulty with and be prepared to raise them during the classroom training. We are here to help. Please note that, we shall be running a very tight schedule during classroom training. So, in order to cover the entire syllabus and as a token of respect to your fellow trainees, we expect the candidates to be specific and concise with their questions. Our classroom training is not a brainstorming or storytelling session. You can also chat or send feedback or questions during e-learning, as well as before and after the classroom. Everybody learns in their own way. So, adopt a style that suits you. Frequent short study periods are better than long intensive sessions. Percentage of exam questions per code and RP. As per API publication effectivity sheet or reference material for API 653 exam, there are 4 codes. API 650 and 653 standards and ASME 5 and 9 codes and 5 recommended practices. 571, 575, 577, 651 and 652, prescribed for examination. However, all of them are not equally important and therefore, do not require equal emphasis. About 45% questions are asked from one code, API 653, which is some 150 pages long, while the rest contribute to 55% marks, which are some 2,000 pages. Code versus approximate percentage of questions. API 653 code and API 575 shall contribute to 50 to 55% of questions. ASME seconds 9 and API 577 shall contribute to 10 to 15% of questions. ASME section 5 shall contribute to 10 to 15% of questions. API RP 571 shall contribute to 5 to 7% of questions. API RP 651 shall contribute to 4 to 5% of questions. API RP 651 shall contribute to 4 to 5% of questions. General knowledge shall contribute to 2 to 3% of questions. Safety shall contribute to 2% of questions. API Core Certificates API 653, 570, 510 API 653 Above Ground Storage Tank Inspector is one of the three core API certificates. The other two are API 510, Pressure Vessel Inspector and API 570, Piping Inspector. These core certifications have some common reference documents between themselves, namely, API 571, API 577, ASME Section 5, and ASME Section 9. Approximately 30% of questions for all three core certifications are derived from above ASME codes and API RPS. Most of the inspectors plan to get at least these three core certifications, so, it makes sense that once you have passed one of them, you may go for other two as well, since you have already covered roughly one-third of the other two examinations. All API examinations including API 653 are held three times a year. And each exam window is 2 weeks long. The exam windows for API 653 for the year 2020 are March 13th to 27, May 29th to July 17th to 31, and November 6th to 20. The API 653 exams for the year 2021 would be more or less along the same windows. The pass rate for API 653 is around 55%. Prometric is subcontracted by API to hold the computer-based examinations. After registering and getting the API approval, you can book an exam date at your selected Prometric test center. Prometric has 3,000 test centers across the globe to choose from. The deadline to get the API authorization email is 2.5 months prior to the selected test window. For exam schedule and application deadline, please visit below link. To get the API approval attending API 653 examination, you need to file the application form by registering with API ICP. Please use below link for registration. Then, upload your qualification. Provide two references and pay the fees. $940 if your company is not an API member, or $730 if your company is an API member. Unfortunately, API does not grant individual membership like ASNT. You can only avail the reduced fee if your company is an API member. Prerequisite. The minimum qualification requirements for API 653 Above Ground Storage Tank Inspector certification are based on the combination of education and experience related to storage tank. This experience must have been acquired within the last 10 years. Prior to submitting an application, please use the table below to determine if you qualify to take the API 653 exam. The minimum experience required must be documented on your application. Verification of your experience by API. API shall verify your claimed experience by sending a link to your two references via email. This link opens up a questionnaire listing your experience in various fields you have claimed, and your references need to verify them. It is recommended to brief your references so they know which inspection fields and for how long you have claimed the experience for. If possible, sit with your references. When they are responding to API experience verification email, this would avoid any discrepancy that may result from your claimed experience against their verification. 2 weeks exam window. Please note that, during registration with API, you are required to select one of the available 2 weeks time window. Once the time window selected, you cannot change it, which means you can only sit for the exam within the selected 2 week window unless you decide to reschedule and pay the fee, $300, which is as good as failing the exam. Remember, if you do not attend the exam within the allocated 2 weeks window for any reason whatsoever, such as being absent or no show up at the exam date, failing to book a slot, non-availability of slot in your preferred test center, and failing to book an available slot in another test center is as good as failing the exam itself. In this situation, you need to request a reschedule and pay $300. The same way as if you failed the exam. Application deadline. The deadline to get your application approved prior to your selected test window is around 2.5 months. If your approval happens at the last minute, you might not be able to find a suitable available date, or worse, you might not be able to get a seat at your favorite test center within the allocated 2 week window, while the next available test center may be hundreds of miles away or even in another country. This is because Prometric has only 3,000 test center offered for API exams across the globe. Hence, it is recommended that you register and get the API approval, called API Exam Authorization Notice email, roughly 6 months prior to your scheduled exam. That is, do not choose the next immediate test window, but choose the one that is 5 to 6 months away. This is especially important for Core API 653 exam. For other non-Core API exams, there is normally a good chance of getting the convenient test location and date of the next available test window. Selecting the test center and exam date. All Prometric testing centers operate on the first-come first-served basis. Therefore, API cannot promise that you will be able to obtain a seat at your preferred location. Schedule your exam immediately after receiving your exam authorization notice email from API. If the seat is not available, try a different date, or another location. You can change the exam location and date still within the allocated 2 weeks window up to 30 days before the exam free of charge, and between 5 to 29 days for a fee of $70 subject to availability. For API core exams, API 653, 570, 653. Being a day-long test, it is hardly possible to change the time and location. Time limit for passing the exam. API gives each candidate 12 consecutive months to pass an exam beginning from the first scheduled test window. This means you can attempt an exam for a maximum of 4 consecutive times. If you do not pass the exam within a year from your first selected exam window for any reason, such as failing the exam, fail to schedule the exam with Prometric, no show at the exam date, etc., you have to apply all over again and pay the full fees. Schedule your exam with your closest Prometric Test Center as soon as you receive the API authorization. One of our trainees received his API exam authorization notice for API 576 months before the selected test window, but attempted to book a place with Prometric only 2 months before the test window. As a result, his closest Prometric Center, London, was already full, so he had to go to Amsterdam Prometric Test Center to attend the exam. Therefore, it is strongly recommend that you book your place as soon as you receive the API authorization notice. Remember, API 653 is a full-day exam, so booking your favorite exam date and location may not be possible if you are late. Prometric booking is on the first-come first-served basis. Be at the Prometric Test Center at least half an hour before the exam scheduled time. API 653 is a day-long exam and normally starts at 8:30 in the morning. Make sure you reach the Prometric Test Center at least half an hour before the scheduled time. If you reach the test center 15 minutes after that, they may refuse to admit you. Photo ID and security check. You will be required to present one valid, unexpired and original government-issued photo ID with a signature, such as a driver's license, passport, national ID or military ID. In cases where a primary government-issued photo ID does not have a signature, a second ID with signature must be presented. The identification must be in Latin characters. Prior to letting you to sit for the exam, Prometric employees shall check your valid government photographic ID, ask you to sign in, check you with a metal detector, ask you to turn up your sleeves and trousers, check your pockets, look at your reading glasses to ensure it does not have any camera or video recording device, and ask you a security question. Date of birth, email address. You cannot carry anything with you except a bottle of water. No ornaments are allowed except a wedding ring. Prometric shall supply you with a couple of green color A4 size papers and a pencil for taking notes, plus a simple calculator. If you don't produce a valid government ID card at the Prometric Test Center, you shall be refused entry and it is treated as a no-show up, which is as good as failing the exam. Also, make sure your government-issued photo ID, driving license, passport is valid. During API 653 exam, one of our candidates' driving license was expired and he was refused entry, although he returned half an hour later with a valid passport, but by that time it was too late, Prometric said. As a result, he had to pay the rescheduling fee, $300, and appear for the exam 6 months later. It is recommended to check your photo ID to ensure it is valid. As plan B, try carrying even two valid photo ID. It is simply not worth it to be refused at the exam center for an ID issue after all the time, effort and money you have spent. Prior to the examination, you shall be given the key to a locker to keep your belongings. You are not allowed to use the locker until you have completed the exam. However, you are allowed to use the locker during the 45 minutes break. Tutorial. There is a tutorial prior to exam and it explains how the bottoms work. You can also find the tutorial via the below link, which is an exact replica of the tutorial you shall see prior to the exam. You can end the tutorial session earlier whenever you feel comfortable enough working with the icons. The exam would automatically start after the 10 minutes allocated time for tutorial or if you end it earlier. The icons are simple and user-friendly. Remember that you can flag off those questions you are not sure of, so you can return back to them during the remaining time. You can also right-click on selected answers to eliminate them, if you are confident that they are definitely the wrong answers. This will narrow down the possible right answers, and therefore increases your chance of getting the right answer. You can either review all the questions once again, or review the flagged-off questions, or review incomplete questions, questions you have not attempted, by clicking on respective tabs during any remaining time left. The exam ends automatically when the remaining time showing on the right-hand corner of the screen reaches zero. No negative marking. The pass mark is roughly 70% for all the API examinations, as API uses scaled grading to standardize the degree of difficulty for all the exams. No negative marking is applied. Therefore, it is recommended to answer all the questions. At the end, click the Review All button and peruse through the list to ensure that you have not skipped any question. You can also check Review Incomplete Questions to ensure there is nothing on the list, that is, no question left unanswered. API 653 Exam Sequence. API core examinations contain two parts. First, you would answer the closed book part, 2 hours, 45 minutes for some 110 questions. After that, you have a maximum of 45 minutes break when you can leave the building and also use the locker. After the break, you would start the second part, open book, and need to answer some 60 questions within 3.75 hours of allocated time. Using the reference documents in PDF format available on the computer screen. The word search is disabled, so you should know which document and also which section you should look for each question. In subsequent modules, we shall explain how you could navigate between documents to find the right answer, chart or formula you need to solve an open book exam question. 45-minute exam break between closed and open book parts. Remember that the open book or second part of the API core examinations automatically starts after the 45 minutes break. Or if you start the second part sooner by pressing the end the break button, this means you should start your second part of examination open book part no later than 45 minutes after completing the first part in order not to lose any time. Try to report to the examination center around 5 minutes before the end of the 45 minutes break. To allow for time spent going through the security check and sign in. During API 570 examinations, one of our candidates went for lunch and returned half an hour late. By the time he started his second part of the exam, he was already some 30 minutes short of the allocated 3.75 hours, because after the 45-minute break, the time for second part of the test, open book, keeps running regardless of whether you are at your desk or not. Tips on time management during exam. Remember, if you need to leave the examination room for, say, using the toilet or drinking water, you need to take your ID with you, report to the security outside the examination room and sign out. On return, you shall go through the same initial security check and sign in. During all this time, the clock is running. Remember, your exam is not concluded until your time is up or when you press the end exam button, which asks for confirmation to ensure that you have not pressed it accidentally. You can also see the list of attempted and non-attempted questions by pressing the Review All button. This would ensure that you have not left a question unanswered. You can see the remaining time at the upper right-hand corner of the screen. There are a few good tutorials in the API ICP Individual Certification Program website. Remember that the clock does not stop when you use the bathroom or when you wish to make a comment on a particular question or for any other reason, so use the allocated time wisely. The allocated time seems to be more than enough to answer all the questions as well as reviewing them. Number of exam questions. There are 170 questions in the core exams, of which only 140 are scored. The remaining 30 are pre-test questions and not marked towards your score, meaning these pre-test questions do not affect your score, whether you have answered them correctly or incorrectly. API does not tell you which ones these questions are. The reason for these non-scored pre-test questions is that API frequently adds up new questions to their existing question bank. API needs to ensure that these questions are not significantly challenged by the candidates and also answered by a reasonable number of people before adding them to their question bank as scored questions. Exam result. Immediately, after completion of the exam, you shall receive an email notifying whether you have passed or failed. Your preliminary exam result may be a preliminary pass, which is normally a pass, a preliminary marginal, which is too close to call, or a preliminary not pass, which is a fail. You shall receive your confirmed score up to 8 weeks after the last day of the 2 weeks examination window, sometime sooner. It takes another 6 to 8 weeks to receive the certification and the wallet card if you have passed. If you fail, you need to apply for rescheduling and pay $300. You shall receive the exam authorization approval email normally within 2 to 3 working days. You shall then book your seat with the Prometric as soon as possible. Certification and recertification. And cost. API 653 certification is valid for a 3-year term and costs $940. After 3 years, you need to apply for recertification demonstrating that you still work as an API 653 inspector for 20% of the time. Recertification costs $730. You may apply for recertification 90 days prior to the certification expiration date, and for a 90-day grace period after. If an application is not submitted by the end of the 90-day grace period, the certification will expire. A new application and the full fee must be submitted, and you will need to pass the full version of the examination in order to be recertified. API inspectors are required to take an online, open book quiz every 6 years in order to recertify. Each quiz has 25 questions that address the changes in the relevant API codes over the past 6 years. You have a total of 4 hours to complete the quiz, and it may be paused or interrupted up to 3 times. If you fail the quiz once, you will be able to take it again. If you fail the quiz a second time, you will not be able to recertify. You will need to submit a new application and take the full version of the exam to certify again. Publications if activity sheet and body of knowledge. Publications if activity sheet is the list of applicable reference documents that you need to study for the exam. It also tells you which sections of each document are applicable. It can be revised from time to time when the codes and recommended practices or their addendum are revised and becomes applicable. Red texts indicate a revision or a change from the previous API activity sheet. Body of knowledge also lists the reference codes and recommended practices without revision number and elaborates on topics that a storage tank inspector needs to know, giving examples. It shows what you are expected to know. Our e-learning is particularly designed around the reference documents and the body of knowledge. Area of examination scores. Below please find a sample score sheet showing the maximum number of score you could achieve for each area. This should give you a fair idea of importance and weightage of each area of knowledge. Content area versus maximum score. Scope and general application 5. Corrosion mitigation 15. Repairs 15. NDE 15. Procedures, limitations, advantages, techniques, responsibilities, applications. Welding 15. Design 10. Planning 20. Inspection and testing practices 15. Data evaluation 24. Roles and Responsibilities 6. Total score 140. Add another 30 non-scored questions that are distributed across the topics. Exam tips. Thickness calculations, round to the third decimal place, and don't round up down. The right answer will be far apart from the wrong answers so as not to pose a problem. Since both metric and British units are used, sometimes, the data are given in inches or foot but the multi-choice answer is in millimeters or meter. So, be careful on unit conversion. API exam never uses the following type of answers. All of the above. Both A and B. None of the above. Use common sense. Reason it out. It is likely a correct answer to a very easy question. A lot of questions are derived from basics. Definitions, meaning, scope, exclusions. Try using the PDF copy of reference documents as much as possible when solving open book questions. It helps navigate through documents more easily during the exam. Sitting for an exam can be stressful, especially for such a day-long gruesome exam, so, try to sleep early the night before and stop reading on the exam day. Just peruse the important parts of the reference documents or look at the figures and charts for an hour maximum. Let your brain rest. You need to be alert and full of energy to endure the day-long core exam. During the exam, you can increase your chances of choosing the correct answer by eliminating the obvious wrong answers. To eliminate the wrong answers, hold the mouse on the answer you think is wrong and right-click. It will cross it, helping you to concentrate on the remaining possible answers. You can challenge any question you may wish by writing on its comment sheet, but please note that the clock keeps running, so you shall be spending from your allocated time. During practice sessions and the mock exams, try actually solving the calculation type mock questions on the paper, not in your mind, even if it is a simple mathematical equation and looks easy. Until you don't practice solving the questions, you would not get the feel of it. Practice also helps you solving the calculations a lot faster while avoid making silly mistakes during the exam. Significant number of questions is aimed at verifying your comprehension of principles and theory, so try to understand the basics rather than simply memorizing the numbers, as it would be of little help. Remember, API does not normally want you to memorize the numbers or formulas during the closed book examinations unless extensively used in the industry, is of everyday use, or specifically mentioned in the body of knowledge. During the remaining modules, we shall show you which figures you may need to remember. Some questions include irrelevant information that might look confusing. API wants to verify that you can differentiate between the relevant and non-relevant information. The trick is to understand the question, what is wanted, and then look at the relevant formula to find out what information is required to calculate the answer. Make a quick list of known and unknown parameters, dismissing the irrelevant information. Then simply use the formula to solve the equation. Pay particular attention to charts, tables, figures, and also the footnotes within the reference books, and try to understand the rationale. We shall explain major tables, chart and figures, and shall point out those important footnotes during our e-learning course and classroom trainings. During open book examination, if you can't find a topic within a code, look at the table of content, the list of figures and tables, if you still can find it within 1 to 2 minutes. Then flag it off, make a note of question number on the paper, and go to next question. There is high chance of encountering the topic when looking for other topics on subsequent questions, in which case you can go back to the flagged off question and solve it within seconds. More exam tips are discussed during other modules and also the classroom trainings if you have opted for the blended package. End of module 1.